The Edgeless Horseman here. I thought I'd talk a bit about Irving Resources and their Omu Sinter project, as well as draw a few comparisons to Fruta del Norte and explain why I really like epithermal deposits. So first of all, here are the resource and reserves for Fruta del Norte indicated. 7.35 million ounces, inferred 2.13, and the deposit looks like this. As you can see, probable reserves of 5 million ounces and the main area of reserves and resources. I think this block here is about 7 million ounces. And the most interesting thing is that the strike length here is only 600 meters and the height is 300 meters. So that's one point I really like about epithermal deposits. I mean, this isn't a big area to drill off, and you still get probably 5 to 7 million ounces just in this area. So I mean, it doesn't take huge amounts of drilling to prove up a pretty large resource, if it's the type of quality, of course, as Fruta del Norte. But just as an observation, if you compare to some of the many hard rock targets, mainly relating to shear zones and stuff like that, that perhaps needs to be drilled off for many kilometers. But this is a very concentrated system. And this is a video from Orania, where they show basically from the other side how it looks. So here you have the sinter, and I would guess that it's about, I don't know, 125-150 meters wide from the side, and as shown here, it's about 300 meters vertical height. This is another picture of Fruta del Norte. Also from the side, you can see a fault here and a fault here. Another one. So you can see from the side, it's very concentrated. And again, the bulk of the gold is captured in 600 meter strike length. So how does that relate to Omu Sinter? Well, first of all, Irving wrote this in one of their news releases after they had, or after Newmont had done this CSAMT survey. They wrote, Irving can now envision with great precision a high-grade target zone encompassing the hanging wall of the principal fault and extending several hundred meters below the boiling zone lithologic unconformity. And just before it says, of particular note, a near-vertical high-res resistive feature projects to depths of 1200 meters. And before that they say, they believe the boiling zone starts at around 380 meters. It is expected that angle holes will need to reach depths of 700 to 900 meters to adequately test the boiling horizon. So if we round that to 400 meters, that's 300 to 500 meters vertical height that they will be testing. And again, Fruta del Norte is quotation marks only 300 meters in height, and and as it says here, these first 8 holes collectively totaling approximately blah 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 test approximately 1 kilometer of strike from north to south along the very large zone of alteration and mineralization underlying the Omu Sinter terrace. All 8 drill holes have intersected long intervals of highly altered volcanic and sedimentary rocks. Notable vein intervals have been intersected in all holes. So basically, even though we haven't gotten the assays and we are not even yet drilling into the boiling zone, they have confirmed the presence of the system of a strike length of approximately 1 kilometer. And this is one of the slides I had in a previous post of mine. So here is where they started out drilling, and they've drilled here, here, and here, and all holes encountered mineralized trend. And one thing I noted was that I was very positively surprised that they were able to find the mineralized trend past this fault line. And I guess that has to do with Newmont's tech, that they're that it's so accurate that they have no problem locating it, even though it might have been displaced. So this is about 1 kilometer in strike length. And again, if we compare it to Fruta del Norte, this is 600 meters strike length, 300 meters height, it contains about 5 to 7 million ounces. Novo is already up to 1 kilometer or so of system strike, and they will be testing 300 to 500 meters vertical depth. And yeah, basically they're gonna drill this wedge target here, which looks pretty much like Fruta del Norte as well, that it basically is broader near the top and gets narrower as it goes further down. So we are still, early days. We haven't put in a single hole into this high-grade target. I just basically want to show that just based on the indicative dimensions of the system, in terms of at least 1 kilometer in strike length, and the survey showing that the target is basically 300 to 500 meters in vertical height, it already compares very favorably to Fruta del Norte, just based on those dimensions. And of course, there are no guarantees. We might not find any quantities of really economic gold values, but just based on the sniffs we've gotten further up in the system, I would be a bit surprised that there would be high-grade gold past the boiling zone, and little amounts of gold in the actual boiling zone. And especially since Irving believes that this lithologic boundary basically is akin to what's present at Hishikari, and that the second gold-rich event, that the fault here had already, it was active basically, so the channels or plumbing that the first silver-rich event was able to use got broken up. So basically there was no easy way for the gold-rich fluids in the second mineralizing event to use the same plumbing and reach the surface. So the theory is that these rocks here, basically around this area, is a favorable host for gold, and instead of the gold, the bulk of the gold fluids having reached the surface, they might be trapped below this lithologic boundary. So I'm very obviously excited about the coming deep drill program. And just based on what we know, if they hit something good in one hole, and we know that it's 1 kilometer minimum of basically strike length of the system already, and that the survey suggests that the high-grade target would be several hundred meters in vertical height, that paints you a picture that just the Omu Sinter alone might be a really really big deposit if everything goes the way we hope. So I expect very interesting news releases in the future. And just to remind myself and others, this is just the first target of four main targets within the Greater Omu Project, and they've staked additional land claims to the west of Hokoryu. So, I mean, they got their hands full already with Omu, and it's possibly an interconnected system. I mean, the fault zones that seem to connect Omu and the Omu Sinter, I think that distance is like 12 kilometers or something. I mean, probably won't all be mineralized, but we have probably the same fault that shows gold content 12 kilometers apart from one another. And then there's a fault to the west which passes Hokuryu and I guess Marianmar or whatever the target name is. So, I mean, I'm very long, Irving, and I just thought I would reiterate why I'm very long, Irving. I mean, there are no guarantees, but just the first project looks huge, and obviously Newmont and perhaps even Sumitomo Corporation is interested in backing Irving, and we got like 7 or 8 projects in the pipeline after that, and we basically have a first mover advantage along with Japan Gold. So I mean, we're probably picking up some prime real estate that would have been staked long time ago if Japan hadn't been closed for mining for 50 years or so. So what is it all worth when you combine the prospects of the prospectivity of Omu, Hokuryu, and Marianmar or whatever the name is, coupled with 7 additional projects and the backing of Newmont? I don't know, but I mean, I don't think Irving is real expensive from a risk reward standpoint, just from what we're seeing at Omu Sinter, and yeah, coupled with the other factors I just mentioned. Well, that's all. Thanks for listening, and subscribe if you like my content. Bye.